Sul Sul surprise buddies, it's Bad Lori on a Saturday. In case you're new here, I'm Bad Lori and I mostly do Let's Plays. If you're not new, you may have noticed that this house looks kind of familiar. I built a new house for Nora, the hero of my tiny island living Rags to Riches series. And it's been quite a while since I've done a speed build for y'all. So here we are, getting a little crazy, a little wild, we're switching things up a little bit, you know, trying some new things out, and here we are. So, I know you're not used to finding me here on a Saturday, so don't get used to it, just enjoy it while you can and while I'm here. And basically, we started this off by smashing up the garbage fire of a house that she had into the ground, and we're starting off with a more conventional shape for the new house. But sometimes, you know, keeping it simple really is better. And I spent some time trying to line up the stairs, like an embarrassingly long time, just because there's no terrain tools and there's no basements on this house, on this lot, so it was a little bit difficult, just, you know, like how it used to be in the old days before they gave us terrain tools again. I forgot how hard it was to work like that. Like, you can see me just kind of like fiddling around, like, ah, make it work, because there's already heights and different levels on this lot existing, but you can't mess with them. So that's where, like, I was getting trouble with the stairs. And then there's this cute little ladder that goes in the back here and doesn't work because it's shallow. Yeah, basically the water in that little area is really shallow, so they can't swim up to the ladder, and that doesn't work. Didn't find that out until I live tested it. Which is fine because it still looks cute back there, and I ended up doing some little stuff with the porch in the last episode of Tiny Island Living anyway. Yeah, so we started off with some wood floors, just making that kind of cute. I wanted to keep a lot of the theme for this house, like mostly browns and warm colors, just because I felt like that seemed more natural to the island life anyway. And after we lined up all those little floor tiles real cute, we kind of put the frame into the house down. And then after we get that painted and wallpapered and we pick out the exact wood pattern that I'm looking for, which we didn't even go with wood, we went with like the reed stuff. I think that's what that is on the walls. I think it's what it was anyway. So we went with that and then, you know, started on the roofing, the bane of my existence. Honestly, I hate watching myself do roofs just because I'm so terrible at it and it's just like so much fiddling in this way and that way. Next time I do a speed build, I might just cut this part out for you guys. Let me know what you think about that. Do you want to watch me make a fool of myself with roofs, or do you want to just, you know, get to the good stuff and watch me be successful at house building? It's all of the ups and the downs, just trying to make that roof look proportionate and trying to make it look normal. It was a challenge, to say the least. But, you know, eventually I persisted and I got through it. She believed she could and she did. And then we went with like the ultra wide doors and really big like open windows too, just because I wanted to keep this house with like that open, breezy island feeling, and so she could really take advantage of all of the views of the island all the time. There's not too much she can do in her tiny house, so at least she can appreciate the natural beauty of the land around her. Yeah, so then once we got like all the windows lined up on here, looking good, still giving her some actual wall space, not overcrowding it with the windows like I wanted to, we move back here and we start building her a little outhouse. So, you're gonna see me kind of like mess around with the frame on this a little bit too, doing some weird finessing and finagling, because what I'm actually doing here is I'm kind of cheating the micro house system, because her whole actual house itself is exactly like 28 squares, and I ended up building her a 6-square bathroom just because I wanted it to have a little bit more room, and the door that I pick out for it is a 2-square door, so I needed that to take up at least 2 squares. Anyway, it's a process, and I'm probably going to rearrange the bathroom eventually anyway, but here I am just messing with the walls a lot, trying to build a little house one wall at a time. Yeah, so eventually we got this second roof settled, and we got the enclosure done, and it's perfect because it's not counting, so now I'm still able to take advantage of all the micro home bonuses. You know, like fast plant growing, better skill gains, you know, better moods. And to be honest, like, since I built her this house, she's been in such a better mood. Like, I am so happy with the house. She's happy with the house. That's what we want. Anyway, you're gonna notice that her bathroom actually has, like, really, really ugly furniture in it. Because this is the off-the-grid lot, I decided to go with all the handmade-looking furniture because I thought that would be kind of cute if it felt like she made it all herself. And to be honest, I'm a little bit disappointed that the game doesn't have things like a rain collection tank and a composting toilet and other things that are like staples of off-the-grid living and tiny house living. Would have given it like a much more realistic experience. So we're just going to use our minds and our imaginations and pretend that this is one of those bathrooms with a composting toilet and that like she gathers rain to use this. Because she can only take tepid, terrible showers anyway, so I'm assuming that she's using rainwater somehow. Also, you're going to notice that I didn't put any floor in the bathroom. That was another thing that I wanted to do to keep it just like super outdoorsy feeling. And yeah, just trying to keep everything within the walls there of that little teeny bathroom was a little bit of a struggle because I had to, you know, alt key and move things around so she could still walk through and use everything. And I'm pretty sure that the bathroom actually does work when I live tested it. Like, I didn't have to finagle anything anymore after we got into the house and tried all that out. Put a little lantern in there, not a lantern, a chandelier. A lot of people are probably going to be mad that the chandeliers I used, they don't size down nicely. Once I plug that in there, you're going to see that it still has the little ring of lights going around the room. But I think that looks cute. It kind of looks ambient. And, you know, we're already using our imagination, so let's just imagine that those little lights aren't there bothering us. And we go back inside where I tried to keep everything like more like brown and green colors just because I like the natural tones in an island setting. It's warm here and I like to bring that warm feeling inside, and it's planty outside, and that's why I wanted to have like pops of green and orange to kind of like represent the plants that are already like existing in her surrounding areas. And unfortunately, I found out that the oven that I put in here was not off the grid friendly, so I did have to replace that after we moved back into the house. That was kind of a struggle because I didn't leave myself enough money for that, but it was okay because now I think that the oven that she has out there now makes more sense because A, it's off the grid, and B, it's kind of like older style, so I feel like maybe she kind of like reclaimed it from somewhere and like fixed it up herself, and that's how she has it. Yeah, there's a lot of backstory into here, I suppose, that I made up for her house while I was building it. I mean, Nora already has a pretty rich backstory. We're like a few episodes deep into her Let's Play now, and she's just like out here living on this island trying to make life work for herself. Yes, and we also have a picnic table here because there's no room for her to eat inside the house, and it's basically always good weather anyway, except for that one time when she tried to have her neighbors over to eat and it rained all over her and the neighbors. Yes, and then we just go in and clutter the house up, as I love to have lots of stuff on the walls and lots of clutter and garbage. We set up a little seating area for her over here with like a little bookshelf because that's going to be her entertainment. It's not like she can read or anything, but I think that maybe eventually I'm going to try to fit like a little easel or something in on the porch. We just got her a cat actually, so during that episode I had to like move things around some more and, you know, make room for the cat. So what you see in the episode isn't exactly what we have here, but it's basically the same house still. I didn't change any of the bones, I just moved the furniture around. Because that's what happens as you live. And yes, we did give her the money trash can, the magical money recycling trash can. And I'm not ashamed of that. I think she needs it, and it's the best way to make money into this game. So we gave her the recycle trash can. Yes. And there we have it. There is her exactly 28 square house. I think it came out really cute. I'm really happy about it. And no, I don't have any screenshots in this speed build for you guys for this house. Because if you want to see how this house looks all put together, just watch my Sulani Sunday's Tiny Island Living series. I make new episodes for that every Sunday. So, you know, hit that subscribe bell so you can get the alerts and be here with me tomorrow when you have the new episode air. But anyway, you know what? Thank you so much for coming and watching this with me today and listening to me bumble through this for the last few minutes. I'm really not good at talking over speed builds. I think that's one of the reasons I wanted to get away from them. But let me know what you guys like better. Do you like my speed builds? Do you like my Let's Plays? I want to hear what you love and what your feedback is. So anyway, thanks for coming to watch this. I appreciate your time. I love you guys so much. Have a good rest of your night, and I'll see you guys all again tomorrow for Tiny Island Living Sulani Sundays. Bye!